This is the solution of assignment number RTBOC007. The first question of the assignment was, which of the following cannot be a structure member? So we know that function cannot be a structure member. We can have another structure as a structure member. We can have array inside a structure. We can also have a pointer inside a structure as in the case of linked list. But we cannot have a function inside the structure in C language. In fact, this is the point in C++. So what C++ has done is that inside structure, it has allowed, so C++ ke andar you can write a structure like this, node, then let us say integer data, then node pointer next. So this is a typical node of a linked list in C language or in C++. In C language, you cannot have a constructor or destructor or any other member of this node. Whereas in C++, I can easily write a node constructor or any other member or any member function. So node that receives an integer value, and it assigns value to data, and next is null, and it doesn't do anything. So C++, in C++ structures are like class. The only difference is that in class, by default, these members of the class, by default, they are all public. They are all private in class. Whereas in case of structure, they are all public. This is the only difference between structure and class in C++. So a structure of C++ is equivalent to a class of Java or C language. Whereas in a structure of C language, I can only have data members. I cannot have functions. This is not allowed. So in C language, I cannot have functions as part of field of the structure. Now, what is the advantage that we get? If a function is allowed as part of structure member, then I can initialize node pointer head is equal to new node 5. So in a single statement, what I have done is I have declared a head pointer. I have asked to allocate a node in a heap, and my constructor accepts one integer value. So maine diya yahan pe 5, usne 5 ko data member mein dal diya aur uska next null kar diya, and head is pointing to this. In C language, to do the same thing, I'll have to do malloc and initialization as two separate things. In C++, I can combine it. So this is the advantage that we get if we can have functions as part of structures, right? If structure is a linked list, if it is not a node, if it is a linked list, then obviously all the object-oriented advantage of abstraction, data hiding, encapsulation, that we can get if we allow functions to be part of structures, all right? So the answer to first question is functions. Second question is, what is the output of the below code? Now this is a very simple thing. The same concept which is in arrays is also used in structures. That if you partially initialize a structure, then there is nothing called partial initialization of structures. So if I have given the default value of one field, then other fields will be initialized by zeros. So age and salaries will be zeros, and name is already given. If I have not initialized at all, agar ye bilkul bhi initialized nahi kiya hua hota, if this has not been initialized, then all the values would have been garbage. All these three values, all these three fields of the structure would have been garbage. Alright, so the answer is 1. Question number 3 is, which of the following comment about union is false? The compiler will keep track of what type of information is currently stored. So this is not true. All other three statements are true. So the answer is first. Question number 4 is, which of the following is collection of heterogeneous data type? Obviously this is structure. So sometimes what we think of is that we confuse generics with heterogeneous data type. Arrays of void pointers. So if I have a void pointer array, void pointer arr, Now, ARR is an array of 5 elements. Each of them are void pointers. So I can have ARR 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So I can have ARR 0 pointing to a character memory, ARR 1 pointing to an integer memory, ARR 2 pointing to a float memory, and so on. But if you look at it, then ARR 0, ARR 1, ARR 2, ARR 3, ARR 4, all of them are of the same data type. They are all void pointers. And void pointer has this, has this capability of pointing to any other memory location, any data memory location. Obviously, void pointers cannot be dereferenced. That's a separate story. But the thing is that array of void pointer is not a heterogeneous data type. It's a homogeneous data type. All right. Array of integer pointers obviously is a homogeneous data type. Structure has fields which can be of different data types. Question number 5. Excuse me. Excuse me. Question number 5. In C language, which of the below statements are true about argument passing to a function? Now, array cannot be passed by L value. Structure arguments are passed by value. Each member of the structure can be passed to a function as argument separately. The answer given is all of the above, all of these. But there is a caveat in this, that there is a way to pass arrays by value. There is a way. Right. By default, obviously, arrays are not passed by values. Then comes question number 6. Question number 6 is, if structure node is defined as below. So it has integer data and one next pointer. So this is a typical node of linked list. This is a linked list node. Then what is the below function doing? So let us say I have a linked list 1, 2, 3, 4, and null. And my head is pointing to this. So head is declared as h. So h is not equal to null. Initially, fun function will be called with the address of 1, address of this node. So let us say address of first node is 100, address of second node is 200, address of third node is 300, address of fourth node is 400. So initially, fun function is called with 100. 100 is not equal to null, so we print the data at 100. Data at 100 means I am printing 1. So 1 gets printed, and then fun function is called again with h arrow next. H arrow next is 200. 200 is also not null, so we print data at 2, data at 200, which is 2. Then fun function is called again with 300. Then 3 will be printed. Fun function is called again with 400. 4 gets printed. Fun function gets called again with null, because next of 4 is null. 4 ka next null hai. Now when h is null, when head is null, the function starts returning. So this function returns to 400. 400 returns to 300. 300 returns to 200. 200 returns to 100. 100 returns to the main function which has called this. Call this fun function. Right? So what this function fun is doing is that it is actually printing all the nodes in forward order. All the nodes of the linked list in forward order. So the answer is that it prints all nodes in the list in forward order. Last question is that what is the output of the below code? Here, structure student. Student has one field which is roll number and another field that is name. I have one student A and one student B. Now the situation is that A, now this, let us say this is A. A ka jo structure hai, that this structure has two fields, A dot roll number and A dot name. A dot roll number is an integer variable. So this is 1. A dot name is a pointer. So this pointer is pointing to a memory location, and that memory location stores Ritambara. This memory location stores Ritambara. I have another variable by the name B. B variable is also of the same structure type. So B variable has B dot roll number and b dot name. B dot roll number obviously is a integer memory. So initially b dot roll number is 5. B dot name को हम क्योंकि हमने initialize नहीं किया है, तो b dot name में garbage पड़ा हुआ है. What we have done is we have said strcpy. Sorry. Then we say structure student b is equal to a. Structure student b is equal to a means. So before initialize before assigning b dot roll number to 5, what we are doing is we are saying b is equal to a. अब स्ट्रक्चर्स में मेंबर बाय मेंबर कॉपी होती है. मेंबर बाय मेंबर कॉपी मींस व्हेन आई से स्ट्रक्चर स्टूडेंट बी इज इक्वल टू ए, इट मींस बी डॉट रोल नंबर इज इक्वल टू ए डॉट रोल नंबर एंड बी डॉट नेम इज इक्वल टू ए डॉट नेम. ईच फील्ड गेट्स कॉपीड. तो बी के रोल नंबर में ए का रोल नंबर आ गया विच मींस 1, और बी के नेम में ए का नेम आ गया. A का नेम इज ए पॉइंटर टू दिस मेमोरी लोकेशन. नाउ B डॉट नेम इज ऑल्सो पॉइंटिंग टू द सेम मेमोरी लोकेशन. नाउ द इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग इज दैट ये जो 1 है, दिस 1 इज गेटिंग कॉपीड बाय वैल्यू. ये वैल्यू की इस 1 की एग्जैक्टली एक कॉपी बन गई है. A डॉट नेम और B डॉट नेम क्योंकि ये पॉइंटर्स हैं, बोथ ऑफ दीज पॉइंटर्स आर पॉइंटिंग टू द सेम मेमोरी लोकेशन. नाउ व्हेन आई से B डॉट रोल नंबर इज इक्वल टू 5, तो B डॉट रोल नंबर हो गया 5, A डॉट रोल नंबर अभी भी 1 ही है. A डॉट रोल नंबर अभी भी 1 है, B डॉट रोल नंबर 5 हो गया. व्हेन वी से strcpy B डॉट नेम मोक्ष, सो व्हाट वी आर सेइंग इज दैट B डॉट नेम जहां पे पॉइंट कर रहा है वहां पे उस मेमोरी लोकेशन पे मोक्ष को स्टोर कर दो. सो आई हैव कॉपीड mokshe मोक्ष हेयर इन B डॉट नेम. बी डॉट नेम को नेम जिस मेमोरी को पॉइंट कर रहा है उस मेमोरी की हमने वैल्यूज को चेंज कर दिया. ए डॉट नेम इज ऑल्सो पॉइंटिंग टू द सेम मेमोरी. सो ए डॉट नेम द वैल्यू एट ए डॉट नेम ऑल्सो गेट्स चेंज्ड. सो व्हेन आई से ए डॉट रोल नंबर इज स्टिल 1 बट ए डॉट नेम इज मोक्ष. सो दिस इज अ टिपिकल केस ऑफ शैलो कॉपी. शैलो कॉपी we will study about shallow copy and deep copy when we will study object oriented programming, but here we are not making a deep copy. Most of you must be aware that you know what is shallow copy, what is deep copy, but here we are not making a deep copy, we are making a very shallow copy. Shallow copy means at one level a dot name and b dot name are different because you know they are storing pointers differently, but at next level they are same. It's a very shallow copy. So the output is 1 moksh. Alright, so these were the 7 questions in this assignment. Thank you.